will come out to the audience, grab you by your ears, drag you outside, and leave you in the snow. So please, put the phones away. There will be a brief 15-minute intermission, at which time snacks and beverages will be sold. Something brand new to Drama Geek Studios are candy grams. If you like, you can send your favorite actor or actress a candy gram, which is located out front by our concession table. I heard Grandpa Joe loves candy. If you'd like to stay up to date with upcoming Drama Geek Studio events, please check us out on Facebook, follow us on Twitter. We also have an Instagram, or you can go to our website at www.dramageekstudios.com. I now ask you, are you folks ready to have some fun? Come on, I've heard more excitement at a bris. Are you folks ready to have some fun? That's better. I will now introduce our live pit musicians. On flute, we have Amanda Lips Freezing. On clarinet, we have Liz Sunshine Uxton. On trombone, we have Alex Hipster Hopkinson. On bass, we have Chloe Flea Hair. On percussion, we have Evan Ringo Silverstein. On trumpet, we have Scotty Knuckles Tomlin. And on piano, our musical director, the always beautiful and incomparable, Dr. Deborah G. Nuzzi. Now come with me on a journey that involves Oompa Loompas, chocolate rivers, and dreams beyond one's imagination as we present Willy Wonka.
Change color every 10 seconds as they dissolve delectably into your mouth. I've also created the biggest and best candy empire the world has ever known. But I have no one to leave it to. No one to replace me. no one to make new candy dreams come true when I retire. And the time for me to retire, alas, is long overdue. Thank you so much. Please gather together all the Oompa Loompas. I have an important announcement to make.
Kisses for you, young misses, soft and creamy, completely dreamy. Chocolate ices with chocolate's prices grow and grow and grow. The day that I retire, I know.
No, 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 no.
There be no more chocolate squiggles, chocolate giggles, chocolate whirlies, chocolate swirlies, chocolate twirlies, all you girlies, chocolate bagels, chocolate bugles, chocolate bubbles.
Charlie's going to work for Mr. Wonka making candy bars.
Oh, crap!
Grandpa Joe, don't go filling the boy's head with dreams of candy.
Brandy? A loved one.
He does not care. Why did he give him brandy?
She said candy.
I know. She's going to give the kids some brandy.
Candy!
What?
Candy!
No need to yell. I'm right here.
But you've got to remember that Charlie is descended from a long line of distinguished candy men.
And women.
But Wonka hasn't hired anyone since Slumber's spy stole his candy balloon recipe.
Oh, he was so angry. We called all of the workers together, and he said, I'm sorry, but you must all go home. And then he closed the gates of the factory forever.
But Wonka still makes candies. I can smell them on my way to school.
Yes, but no one goes in and no one comes out.
Shadow
of Maybe the undead, who knows?
Grandpa Joe, you're going to give Charlie nightmares again.
What? Charlie wants some gin.
We're having gin.
Morning.
Charlie, we're never seeing anyone stuck with today's newspaper.
Okay, Dad, it's time to feed Grandpa George.
Boss. All right, Pop. Here's a Gavin suit.
But I thought we were having gin.
See these kids? They meet outside Charlie's house every day after lunch with 50 pence apiece to buy a Wonka bar from the local candy man. The only kid with no money is Charlie.
Come on, Charlie, I'm bringing candy.
Not today. I'm on a special diet.
It's working. Well, anyways, help me pick me up. I've got 50 pence.
You've already got a lollipop. Shouldn't you finish it first?
I just can't help it. I just love candy. Chocolates, caramels, strawberries, as stuck as anything.
Stop it. You're making my mouth water.
I can't stop eating sweets. All those wonderful Willy Wonka treats. You can keep the others, cause me, I'm a walker.
When it comes to candy, Willy's the conqueror, the walker.
With love, it makes the world taste good.
Here's the paper, Dad.
Oh. We'll all be a chocolate crispy. Will you look at this? Wonka factory to be open to a lucky few.
Do you mean they're actually going to allow people inside the factory?
Read what it says.
Mr. Willy Wonka has decided to allow 5 children to tour his world famous chocolate factory. The lucky 5 will tour the factory, and 1 will win a lifetime supply of Wonka chocolate.
The factory?
Lifetime supply of chocolate?
Read on!
5 golden tickets have been hidden among 50 million ordinary candy bars.
Well, that's, what, 10 million to 1? Wow, I don't like those odds.
Find that these golden tickets will win the tour, and 1 will win the chocolate.
Boy, what are you all talking about?
Wonka's having a contest.
Why are we going to the screen test?
A contest!
Who is?
Wonka!
What about him?
He's having a contest!
All right, I'm not deaf, you know.
Those golden tickets could be anywhere! How exciting! I wonder if any of them have been found yet. That paper's a day old.
Charlie, can you imagine Winnie?
Pouring the factory.
Meeting Mr. Wonka.
Seeing all those undead zombie workers for yourself.
Eating a lifetime supply of chocolate.
Eating a lifetime supply of chocolate.
Oh, is it 1 o'clock already? Charlie, you better hurry, you'll be late for school.
Well, it's back to the twists and turns of toothpaste caps for me.
Goodbye, Mr. Bucket.
Goodbye, Mrs. Bucket.
Charlie, come here. I want you to remember, we may be starving.
Starving?
We may be poor.
Poor, the church might.
But the Bucket family always thinks positive.
Charlie. Psst, Charlie.
Yes, Grandpa George?
Come here. Come over here.
What is it, Grandpa George?
Charlie, remember, we may be starving. Maybe poor.
We've already done that.
The Bucket family.
Always thinks positive. I know, Grandpa George, I know.
I don't know what I was going to say.
Charlie, tell you what, write it down in purple ink. This way, if it's in purple ink, you'll never forget.
Now that's positive. Ha!
Little Charlie Bucket was off to school, but on the way, he heard some exciting news.
Their name is pronounced Gloop, with the G and an L and an O and another O and a P. G-L-O-O-P. Galoop. And this is my klein Liebeschen Augustus.
Well, tell me about that ticket.
Oh, yeah. I just knew Augustus would find the golden ticket. He ate so much candy, family, that it was almost impossible for him not to find one.
Impossible, yeah.
So, Augustus, why don't you tell the folks at home something about you? What do? Do you have any favorite subjects or hobbies?
Yeah, food. Augustine, food, yeah. Lots and lots of food, yeah.
Yeah.
Well, eating is his hobby. Oh, he is devoted to it. Oh, my God, is he devoted.
Well, critics may say that Augustus is a questionable role model for today's youth, given the alarming rise in childhood obesity.
So he's a little fat. What's wrong with that? It is better than being some sort of a hooligan, running around and raising the havoc and shooting the guns, isn't it, my little piggly wiggly?
Javon, mommy dearest, javon.
And don't I always say what I always say? Say it with me, Augustus. Eat more, eat more, eat more. Boy. Say it again, Augustus. Eat more. You know, we've been training for this day ever since my little smudgy pudgy was born.
Training?
Yeah. For the young to eat as much as Augustus, you must be in training from morning till night, eating all kinds of the foods. If eating were the Olympics, Augustus would have all the medals.
Mushrooms with bread rolls and buns by the reel. Und coffee, und toast bread, und butter, und marmalade,
and sweetmeats,
and meat treats galore.
And what does Augustus do when breakfast is through?
I eat more. He has bratwurst for luncheon, the size of a truncheon, und pasta, und foie gras, und soup.
I eat more.
Between meals the cook feeds me all types of goodies, like chocolates or puddings or snacks.
You must understand, young Augustus is so highly strung, eating helps him relax.
Mom has Wonka bar scented in sacks.
I'll make certain there's nothing he lacks.
Then dinner.
Macadamia nuts. If it's nuts you want, it's nuts I got. People go nuts for my nuts. Check us out at www.trymynuts.com.
Want to know about my tickets, not your macadamias.
Right you are, pigeon. Right you are. Give us a call at 1-800-WOOD-NUTS. The major account accepted.
The ticket, Mr. Salt.
Right. So, after I bought hundreds of thousands of Wonka bars, I had my factory go to start shelling nuts and start shelling wrappers.
Oh, okay. So, how many wrappers did Victoria shell?
None, you pea brain. Veruca doesn't do manual labor. We have people for that. And my daddy will have you fired for mispronouncing my name. Don't you, Daddy?
Anything you want, my precious, anything you want. So after days of shelling hundreds of thousands of wrappers, one of my factory girls finally found one of those nice golden tickets. I let her take the candy bar home to her 13 children, you know. I didn't have the heart, Ma, too, you know what I mean?
How philanthropic.
Daddy, now he's being sarcastic. I want to fire.
This is Phineas trap where it seems the sweet is rapidly turning sour.
With nuts. Don't forget my nuts.
Yes, it seems you can't have chalk without the nuts. Good luck, Vivian.
It's my
rainbow! Oh. So there you have it, folks. After just one day, only 3 golden tickets remain. Stay tuned for continuous coverage of this extraordinary contest. And let's hope there's just one kid deserving among the 5. Trout.